Hello everyone. Today I am going to discuss part 20 lecture of electrochemistry, and following topics will be discussed in this lecture. Topics are electrolyte concentration cell without transference and solved examples on concentration cell. Now see the first slide, types of electrolyte concentration cell without transference. So now if you are new to this channel, see my last lectures of concentration cell where I have discussed different types of concentration cell. Remember, concentration cell are of two types, electrode concentration cell and electrolyte concentration cell. Electrolyte concentration cell are of two types, electrolyte concentration cell with transference and this one electrolyte concentration cell without transference. Now, electrolyte concentration cell without transference are of two types. Number one is reversible to cation and number two is reversible to anion. Now see, here is the example of reversible to cation, platinum H2, 1 atmosphere pressure, HCl activity A1, HCl activity A2, H2 atmosphere, H2, 1 atmosphere pressure, platinum electrode, A2 greater than A1. So this is the example of reversible to cation. Now see here, the most important part here, you have to use a double vertical line, which indicates that here you have to use a salt bridge. The two solutions, these two electrolyte solutions are not in direct contact with each other. And also see here, the electrode concentration are same, but the electrolyte concentrations are different. Now consider the example of reversible to anion, and here it is given Ag, AgCl, HCl, activity A1, again double vertical line, HCl, activity A2, AgCl, Ag electrode. Here activity A1 greater than activity A2. So again you can see I have used here a double vertical line, that means these two electrolytes are not in direct contact with each other through a porous partition, but you have to use a salt bridge. Now, first consider electrolyte concentration cell without transference reversible to cations. So here you can see a cell diagram. This is the platinum electrode, and here you can see this is the cell notation, platinum electrode, H2 here, 1 atmosphere pressure. Here also you can see H2, 1 atmosphere pressure, platinum electrode. So the pressure of hydrogen gas in both electrodes are same. That's why it is not a electrode concentration cell. But if you see the concentration of the electrolyte, here the HCl acts as an electrolyte. And here you can see the activity of HCl is A1. Here this is another electrolyte, the same electrolyte. It is HCl activity A2. So the concentration, or you can say the activities of these two electrolyte are different, so it is called electrolyte concentration cell. Why it is called without transference? Because these two electrolyte are not in direct contact with each other, and you have to use this salt bridge. That's why you have to add a double vertical line. Now this cell is reversible to cation H+, because only H+ takes part in the overall reaction. Now you have to know what is the cell reaction. Here you can see this is a negatively charged electrode and here is a positively charged electrode. So what will happen? Electron flows from negatively charged electrode to the positively charged electrode. Now here you can see the electricity will be produced by electrons movement only. So it is not like electrolyte concentration cell with transference, where the electricity is produced by electrons movement and also ions movement. But here you can see these two electrolytes are not in direct contact with each other, so there is no ions movement from one half cell to the other half cell. Now you have to know what is the shell reaction. Here is the left hand electrode, so here the oxidation takes place. So what is the anode reaction? Half H2 converts to H+, activity A1 plus electron. Okay, activity here is A1. Now, what is the cathode reaction? H plus takes the electron and converts to H2 gas. Okay, so this is the cathode reaction or reduction reaction. So now, what is the overall reaction? Overall reaction is given here, H plus activity A2 converts to H plus activity A1. So this is equation number 3, and this is the overall equation. Now you can see in this overall cell reaction, the cell depends on the concentration of H plus, that is cation. That's why the cell is reversible to H plus. Now you have to know what is the Nernst equation. You know this is the formula E is equal to E0 minus 0.059 by 1. Why it is 1? Because number of electron change is 1 here. So 1 log concentration of the product. So this is the product A1 concentration divided by this is the reactant A2 concentration. Now you know that E0 for such type of cell is equal to 0 because E0 is equal to ER minus EL and both electrodes are same, that's why E0 is equal to 0. Now you can write E cell is equal to minus 0.059 by 1 log A1 by A2 and you can write this equation E cell is equal to 0.059 by 1 log A2 by A1. So this is equation number 1. Now, if A2 greater than A1, then E cell will be positive and the reaction will be spontaneous. So here you can see when A2 greater than A1, the reaction is spontaneous. That's why here you can see A2 greater than A1 is written. Now for single ion, you know that activity A is equal to molality into activity coefficient. That's why you can write A2 is equal to M2 gamma 2 and A1 is equal to M1 gamma 1. Now put the value of A2 and A1 in this equation, equation number 1, you will get this equation. E is equal to 0.059 by 1 log M2 gamma 2 by M1 gamma 1. So this is equation number 2. Now consider electrolyte concentration cell without transference reversible to anions. So here you can see this is a diagram for such cell. Here I have used a silver chloride electrode and this is the right hand electrode. It is also silver chloride electrode. So both electrodes are same, but electrolytes concentration are different. Here the concentration of HCl is A1. Here the concentration of HCl is A2. Okay, so this is the shell notation and here you can see the concentration of A1 greater than A2. Again, you can see this is a double vertical line, so this is a salt bridge. Now, this cell reaction only depends on concentration of Cl minus. That's why the cell is reversible to anion Cl minus. Now, you have to know what is the cell reaction. Here again, you can see this is the negatively charged electrode because here the oxidation takes place, left-hand electrode, and here the reduction takes place and it is positively charged electrode. So what will happen? Electron flows from negatively charged electrode to the positively charged electrode. Again, you can see electricity will be produced by electrons movement only because there is no ions movement. Why there is no ions movement? Because these two electrolytes are not in direct contact with each other. Now what is the anode reaction? Anode means oxidation reaction. Here you can see the oxidation reaction Ag plus Cl minus having activity A1 converts to AgCl plus electron. So this is first equation, equation number 1, first cell reaction, anode reaction. Now consider what is the cathode reaction? AgCl plus electron converts to Ag plus Cl minus activity A2. Okay, so this is equation number 2. Now you have to know what is the overall reaction. Overall reaction is given here, Cl minus activity A1 converts to Cl minus activity A2. So equation number 3. Now you have to know what is the Nernst equation. So here again you can see E cell is equal to E0 cell minus 0.059 by 1. 1 number of electron change, here is 1 log activity A2 product thereby reactant concentration, that is A1. Again, you know that E0 cell is equal to standard electrode potential difference, that is equal to 0. And you can write E cell is equal to minus 0.059 by 1 log A2 by A1. And finally, you can write E cell is equal to 0.059 by 1 log A1 by A2. So this is equation number 1. And in this equation number 1, you can say that if A1 greater than A2, then E cell will be positive and reaction will be spontaneous. Because E cell is positive means delta G0 is negative and reaction will be spontaneous. So here it is written A1 greater than A2. Now for single ion, you know that activity is equal to concentration into activity coefficient. So here the concentration is expressed in terms of molality again. And activity coefficient A is equal to M into gamma. Now you know that A1 is equal to M1 gamma 1 and A2 is equal to M2 gamma 2. So put the value of A1 and A2 in this equation number 1. You will get this is the final equation, equation number 2. E is equal to 0.059 by 1 log M1 gamma 1 by M2 gamma 2. Okay. So now we can see the electrolyte concentration cell without transference reversible to cations or reversible to anions does not depend on the transport number of the cations or anions. But if you see my last lecture, lecture 18 and lecture 19, where I have discussed electrolyte concentration cell with transference reversible to cations and anions, and you can see there that the final E cell depends on the transport number of cation or transport number of anion. Now see numericals on concentration cell. First, see question number 1. Calculate the concentration of unknown from the cell given below and a cell potential of 5.2 millivolt. So here you can see the cell is given zinc sulfate concentration X. You have to find what is the value of X in this cell. Double vertical line, ZN sulfate, concentration is 0.15 molar, vertical line zinc. Now from that cell notation, you can see the concentration of the electrolytes are different. So this is an example of electrolyte concentration cell. And this is the double vertical line. That means this is a cell without transference. Okay, so this is electrolyte concentration cell without transference. And here you can see ZN oxidizes to ZN2 plus on the left hand electrode, and here ZN2 plus reduces to zinc ZN. So here is the reduction, and it only depends on the concentration of ZN2 plus. That's why it is reversible to cations. Now see the cell reaction, anode reaction here, ZN to ZN2 plus, plus 2 electron. X is the unknown concentration, equation number 1. Cathode reaction, ZN2+, concentration is given, 0.15 molar plus 2 electron converts to ZN, equation number 2. Now what is the overall reaction? ZN2+, 0.15 molar converts to ZN2+, concentration unknown. This is equation number 3. Now you know that E cell is equal to E0 cell minus 0.059 by 2. 2 is the number of electron change. Okay, that is 2. And log X product divided by concentration of the reactant, that is 0.15 molar, so 0.15. Now E0 cell is equal to 0, so you can write E cell is equal to minus 0.059 by 2 log X by 0.15. E cell is given, it is 5.2 millivolt, now convert by millivolt into volt, that is 5.2 10 to the minus 3 volt is equal to 0.059 by 2 log X by 0.15. Log X by 0.15 is equal to 2 into 5.2 10 to the minus 3 divided by 0.059, that is equal to minus 0.176. So X by 0.15 is equal to 10 to the power minus 0.176, and that is equal to 0.6668. Now calculate what is the value of X, multiplying 0.6668 with 0.15, and that is here. X is equal to 0.1 molar. Okay. So you can see the value of X is equal to 0.1 molar, and here you can see the value is 0.15 molar. So here you can see A2 greater than A1. That's why the E cell is positive and the reaction is spontaneous. Now see question number 2. Calculate the EMF of the following cell at 25 degrees Celsius. You can see that is given Ag initial, HCl. You can see molality. It is given 0.2, gamma 1, 0.94, double vertical line. HCl, M2, 0.01, gamma 2, 0.97, HCl, Ag. Now we can see, again you can see the electrolytes concentration are different. So this is an example of electrolyte concentration cell. And you can see double vertical line. So this is without transference. And here if you see the cell reaction, which depends on the concentration of Cl minus. So this is reversible to anions. So see the cell reaction here. Anode reaction Ag plus Cl minus, activity A1 converts HCl plus electron, equation number 1. Cathode reaction reduction, HCl plus electron converts to Ag plus Cl minus, activity A2, equation number 2. And this is the overall reaction, Cl minus A1 converts to Cl minus A2, equation number 3. Okay, so the cell only depends on the concentration of the anion, so reversible to anions. Now here you can see already I have discussed how to calculate the initial for such reaction. That is equal to ECL is equal to 0.059 by 1 log M1 gamma 1 by M2 gamma 2. Here it is important to mention that you can remember this formula or you can derive this formula. Now put the value of M1 gamma 1. M1 is given 0.2, gamma 1 is 0.94, 0.2 into 0.94, M2 0.01 into 0.97. Okay. So ECL is equal to 0.05 by 1 log 0.188 divided by 0.0097. Now ECL is equal to 0.059 by 1 into 1.58. So ECL is equal to 0.076 volt. So the EMF for this cell at 25 degrees Celsius is 0.076 volt. Now see question number 3. The EMF of the following cell at 25 degrees Celsius is 0.082 volt. Ag, HCl, HCl, molality M1 is equal to 0.1, gamma 1 is equal to 0.95. Single vertical line, HCl, M2, 0.01, gamma 2, 0.98, HCl, Ag. Calculate the transport number of H plus and Cl minus. Now see the answer. Again, you can see the concentration of the electrolytes are different. So example of electrolyte concentration cell. And here you can see, this is a single vertical line. That means it is with transference. That these two electrolytes are in direct contact with each other. And if you see the cell reaction, that depends on the concentration of the anions only. So it is reversible to anions. See the cell reaction, Ag plus Cl minus, activity A1 converts to HCl plus electron. Cathode reaction, HCl plus electron converts to Ag plus Cl minus, activity A2. And this is the overall reaction, Cl minus A1 converts to Cl minus A2. And this is equation number 3. So it only depends on the concentration of the anions. So it is reversible to anions. Now if you see my part 19 lecture, where I have discussed how to calculate the E cell for electrolyte concentration cell with transference reversible to anions. And the formula is given here, E cell is equal to 2T plus 0.059 by 1 log M1 gamma 1 divided by M2 gamma 2. Now put the value of M1 gamma 1. That is here 0.9 to 0.95, M2 gamma 2 0.01 into 0.98. So E is equal to 2T plus 0.05 by 1, 1 is equal number we have to change, log 0.059 by 0.0098. So ECL is equal to 2T plus into 0.058. That means if you multiply 0.059 into log this value, you will get 0.058. So ECL is equal to T plus into 0.116, and ECL is given here 0.082, put the value 0.082 is equal to T plus into 0.116. So T plus is equal to 0.082 divided by 0.116, and that gives the value of T plus is equal to 0.71. So this is the transport number of cation H plus. Now calculate the transport number of Cl minus. from that equation, t minus is equal to 1 minus t plus. So 1 minus 0.71 is equal to 0.29. So the transport number of H plus is 0.71 and transport number of Cl minus is 0.29. Now see question number 4. The EMF of the concentration cell 1 and 2 at 25 degrees Celsius are 0.039 volt and 0.065 volt. First cell you can see platinum H2 1 atmosphere pressure, H cell activity A1, single vertical line H cell activity A2, hydrogen 1 atmosphere pressure, single vertical line platinum, and for second cell platinum H2 1 atmosphere pressure, single vertical line H cell activity A1, double vertical line H cell activity A2, H2 1 atmosphere pressure, platinum electrode. Calculate the transport number of H plus and Cl minus ions. Here, remember A1 and A2 for cell 1 and 2 are same. That means this A1 value and this A1 value are same, and this A2 value and this A2 value are same. But A1 not is equal to A2. So here again you can see the A1 and A2 are different. So these two cells are example of electrolyte concentration cell. But if you consider cell number 1, here you can see I have used a single vertical line. So this is electrolyte concentration cell with transparency. But if you consider cell number 2, double vertical line, so this is an example of electrolyte concentration cell without transparency. Now see the answer. First cell, already I mentioned that first cell is electrolyte concentration cell with transparency and it is reversible to cations. And the second cell, electrolyte concentration cell without transference, reversible to cations. So first one is with transference, second one is without transference. Now if you see the anode reaction, half H2 converts to H plus plus electron. Okay. And if you see the cathode reaction, reduction H plus plus electron converts to half H2. So what is the overall reaction? H plus activity A2 converts to H plus activity A1. This is equation number 3. And in this overall cell reaction, you can see the cell depends on the concentration of only H plus. That's why it is reversible to cations. Now, electrolyte concentration cell with transference reversible to cations, you know this is the formula. And I have discussed the formula in my lecture 18. E with transference is equal to 2T minus 0.059 by 1 log M2 gamma 2 divided by M1 gamma 1. And electrolyte concentration cell with transference reversible to cations, I have discussed this cell in this lecture. And E without transference is equal to 0.059 by 1 log M2 gamma 2 divided by M1 gamma 1. Now, what you can say? E with transference divided by E without transference is equal to 2t minus 0.059 log m2 gamma 2 by m1 gamma 1 divided by 0.059 log m2 gamma 2 divided by m1 gamma 1. So if you cancel log m2 gamma 2 by m1 gamma 1 and 0.059, you'll get E with transparency divided by E without transparency is equal to 2t minus. Now put the value of E with transparency. That is E with transparency, cell number 1, that is given here 0.039, and E without transparency, that is given 0.065. To put the value here, 0.039 by 0.065, that is equal to 2t minus. Therefore, t minus is equal to 0.30, and t plus is equal to 1 minus t minus, that is equal to 0.70. So the transport number of H plus, that is cation, is 0.70, and transport number of anion, that is Cl minus, is equal to 0.30. Thank you.
Finally, my request to my students, please subscribe my channel. Thank you.